science. What we're doing with this activity is we are talking about light. And we will be using a flashlight to test these different materials to see if light will pass through them. And again, a flashlight is a light source, and these are our non-light sources. So our materials, again, we just walked around the planetarium and gathered items, and again, they could be things that you find around your house. So let's go ahead and get started and test which items that light will pass through. So now some three science terms that we're going to talk about is transparent, translucent, and opaque. So transparent is when a light source can pass through it completely, and we'll use the whiteboard to demonstrate. Translucent is when some light gets through, and then opaque is when light is completely blocked from shining through. So with your kiddos at home, you can gather items with them. I laid them out in a varying order so we can group them together. So first I have some saran wrap. And you can see through it, so what you'll do is just turn your flashlight on. When I shine it through, you can definitely see light does pass through. So that would mean that saran wrap is transparent. I'll just set it here. Next, let's do cardboard. And we just remove this from just a toaster pastry box laying around. So let's just shine our flashlight, and when you look, light is completely blocked from entering, so this would be opaque. Here. And then we have wax paper that we found. And when you shine this through, you can see that some light does pass through. So this is in fact referred to as translucent. So I have three separate piles of transparent, translucent, and opaque. Let's test our tray. No light passes through clearly, so that would be opaque. We have two more. We just have a 9-ounce clear plastic cup, and when you shine light through, it's clear that all the light passes through. So this is again transparent, like our plastic wrap. And for our last item, we have a pitcher that we found. It is a little dingy, it's a little older, but we used it to demonstrate that you have to look a little closer, but some light does in fact pass through. So since some light enters, but not all, this would be considered translucent. Thanks again for watching Soul Museum and Longway Planetarium's Daily Dose of Science. If you could please like, share, post comments, videos, pictures of you replicating these experiences at home, we would love to see it here at Soul Museum and Longway Planetarium. And when you do that, could you please include the hashtag SL_DailyDose. Thanks again for watching.